Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of Skyward Sword HD Hero Mode. I am Makoto Jado, and we are currently looking for a boat. Well, a ship. Ship, boat, boat, ship. Floating device. A seafaring apparatus, if you will. With the sea chart, we can now see everything. And I hit the A button, didn't I? Yes, I hit the A button. Set sail, please. There we go. I'm just curious. If you're on some type of boat or sea vessel, is it considered bad luck to start singing the theme to Gilligan's Island? I missed. Twice. So yeah, there was really no point in doing that, I just felt like it. I've also managed to find all the fucking rocks in the sea. Everybody huddle up now. I completely missed. That was fantastic. Welcome to ye olde shipyard. Also, welcome ye olde thunderstorm. Hopefully we don't lose power. That would suck. We have arrived! This is where the ship was built. Surely there's some sort of clue in here. And the entrance is closed. We must go all the way around. Hello, I can totally words, I promise. Did I mention don't forget to check the bird statues? Very important, that one. Oh, hey, they blocked that. Ow. Oh, come on. Oh, by the way, it can shield bash their fire breath. That makes total sense. Hey, how's it going? I'm just gonna sit here. Anyway, how's it going? Safety information. Approach the cart. Lean your body to balance the weight. B to slow down. Jump up to clear obstacles. And suddenly roller coaster. Anyway, lean in on the turns, you'll go faster. Oh, After all this is said and done, you can come back, do this a couple times, get a piece of heart. If you really want to. That was just a terrible time to use up all my stamina. To the construction bay! Moving along! Be sure to lean in the direction you want to go to. Whee! Almost there. Pretty sure this is a violation of safety. Get our couple rupees, get me my heart back. I don't think this one matters, because I don't think this one... Yeah, you can't teleport to that one. Too bad. Master, we have arrived at the ship construction bay. Since nobody has been here in thousands of years, everything's filled with sand somehow. I literally do not see an opening to where that can happen. Huh. Hope the plans for my ship are completed soon. I never noticed that before. Ain't that interesting. Give me my 2 rupees. Oh, look! Remember this guy? Anyway, it's just straight up. Same as the boss fight. Literally no difference. I don't even think it has any more health or anything to compensate. Got no claws. Me hitting wrong buttons. Get this guy back out the sand. And bada bing, bada boom, stab. Explosions. Master, it would appear that many of years on these factory blah 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 set up his nest. Tried to kick your ass, failed. No, hey, I didn't even take any damage that time. Oh, look! A giant circle. With that done, we go back to Skipper here. And say, hey man, there was nothing in there. Let's go! This is pretty scary. No, not really. Huh. Ring, neighborhood alert near where I live. Flash flood watch! Really? You know, luckily for me, I live up on a giant hill, so if it floods, we literally take no... There's no consequence for us. Unless, of course, it knocks power out somehow. It's like, flood? What flood? We're on top of a mountain. We ain't got no flood. Oh, hey, got us keep. Yes, of course you'll wait here. Let's see here. One, two, 300 rupees. Oh, hey, Monster Claw. Oh, hey, electrocution. Well, I should say shocking. Anything in the barrels. Bombs I don't need. Ew. Yeah, I'm just gonna go right around you people. Ha I don't know why, though, people always say, oh, electrocuted when they got shocked. Because, see, electrocute is the combination of the words electricity and execution. Therefore, if you were electrocuted, you'd be dead. Therefore, if you only received a jolt, you would only be shocked. The more you know... Oh, hey, I was actually missing two bombs. So I could have used those bombs. Oh, well. Wow. Alright, seriously. Seriously. Give me your tail. You ain't nothing without your friend. Oh, that was terrible. There we go. Moving on along. We get our time shift orb. Not a stone, a time shift orb. With the time shift orb, we can make it mobile. Tra-la-la-la-la. Mobile time! Oh, crap. Oh, crud. Can even somewhat throw it. Get absolutely nothing in those, that's great. Oh shit! And that's Fi saying, hey, you're about to die! Need to be careful where we put those. Because they will activate the laser traps. And laser trap activation is bad. I think this one we literally just want to build our platform, yeah. I really like the time shift orbs and stuff, man. It's a really clever puzzle. Man, it's probably one of the coolest ideas for a Zelda puzzle. I don't know how that worked, but I'll take it. Let's see, if we get too close, a wall pops up in front of the chest. So you gotta be careful with that. Get us another evil crystal. Crystals that are evil, You notice I keep trying to eat this thing. Wrong button. Wrong button. Move, woo. Anyway, what I was trying, motherfucker. What I was trying to say is moving along. Die. Ugh. Go ahead and get rid of you. No fair, I was busy. All according to plan. not really. Anyway, moving along here. We don't want to do that too much, but we want to do that enough to activate the button. I may have done this wrong. We'll see. Oh, nope. Here we go. Just enough. Oh! That could have been bad. That could have been really bad. Anyway, what we want to do is we just want to place the orb right there. They point out the oh-so-obvious lever. Lever switch, whatever. I'm getting a lot of those. Let's see. Hop up. Oop, missed. Open up our magic door and get the magic ball. And beat the hell out of these guys. Damn it. And then we place it here, which magically amplifies its power or something? I don't know. It does something to do the thing, so that happens. And we gotta go gadget opened up. And then that door opens. A report! Time for stone seeds have changed ship. I could not tell by the giant. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I don't think I've ever noticed this before. Oh, that may have been a mistake. Okay. Never mind. But wait. That's confused. Okay, it doesn't matter. Ignore me. Just, yeah. Doing stuff. By doing that, we basically can run through here and Fi will tell us, hey, guess what? These shells. These cells are from the ship that protects Nehru's flame. We can now douse for the invisible ship. That is helpful. However, if you remember from when we first came through here... Oh, wait. Give me the foo. If you remember when we first came in here, there is a goddess cube up here. Easily missed if you're overzealous or something. Or if you're just not paying attention during the opening cutscene. Happens to anybody. I was trying to roll through that. Anyway, it's all good. In the hood. Yeah, your ship wasn't there either, ain't that something? To see! Alright, here's essentially the only time I ever use this. Well, actually, there's one more time that I occasionally use this, but... That's later. Sea kill. Let's see here. Dows, and we'll finally eventually get to it. This is just basically a game of hide and seek. Nope. Wait a minute, where? There we go. Anyway, get about 3 shots off on this damn thing. And it's suddenly visible. Looks a bit worse for wear, though. And welcome to the Sand Ship, essentially our next dungeon. Anyway, that'll be all for this episode. On the next episode, we're gonna get cracking. Thanks, like, subscribe, still can't talk. Like, comment, subscribe.